From Studio 1A in Tampa, Florida, comes a talk show that really feels your pain and tells you like it is. We love America and all that freedom-loving Americans want to protect. Live from coast to coast and on your radio, it's For the People with Keith Allen.
We'll help you survive this thing called life.
Well, hello, Mr. and Mrs. America. I am Keith Allen and proudly welcoming you into this Monday's edition of For the People on a December the 4th, 2017. We got a big show lined up for you. And today is going to be no different other than tomorrow. I have to preview it just slightly. A little about a format because, you know, we talk politics and, you know, social issues and health and science and just kind of a mixture of things. But tomorrow we're going to be talking about police brutality that's happened to some folks around the country. And we're going to go to Neenah, Wisconsin, and there has been some cases up there that still baffle my mind and baffle the citizens up there. And we'll be hearing from some other places around the country, too, that have had this happen before. But ways that you can help, ways that they're helping, and things that you may not have thought about, but their stories revealed on national radio, and we're going to give them a platform to help their organization because they're doing a lot of good combating the real evils that are out there, unfortunately, on our streets today. And there's too much of it, and unfortunately, bad apples that are law enforcement officials and for those that protect them, even though that they know that they're bad apples. And we're trying to root them out, and I think that's what they're trying to do, really, in a nutshell. All right, our first story is Kate's Wall. Because of the acquittal of this illegal that still, that baffles my mind, I can't say that it was an utter surprise, because California, San Francisco, they have the most liberal policies, the most liberal people. On the judges, the law enforcement officials, they seriously welcome these type of cats into their city. That's what I call it. I mean, they welcome them. They welcome illegals that have raps, that three, four, five felonies. They've hurt people, drug lords. They don't care. They welcome them. Come to San Francisco. We'll shelter you. Will allow you to get away with murder. Murderers will allow you to have sanctuary in our city. Well, I got to tell you, folks, I am not going to San Francisco anytime soon. I could care less. And I understand it's beautiful. I have friends in media that work at some of the stations out there. I have no fascination with going to visit vacation out there, not until their policies change, mainly towards defending these lunatics that are killing our citizens on the streets of San Francisco. It's not just San Francisco, but just pointing this out, just the lunacy of the left allowing Garcia Zarta to be able to plead not guilty for killing Kate Steinle, saying that his bullet was meant for the SEALs. It was meant for the SEAL. It wasn't meant for her. It ricocheted. It was meant for something else. The guy was a repeat offender, illegal alien, who had a gun that was not his gun, that he shot. Even an involuntary manslaughter charge would have been adequate. But no, literally got away with his poor girl's death. You want to talk about lunacy? This infuriates any level-headed thinker, God-fearing American with a conscience for this 32-year-old that was gunned down in front of her dad. Can you imagine, as a father, to see your daughter mowed down, killed, and then to find out there's an acquittal? Are you kidding me? Folks, a lot of people are just infuriated and beyond belief. I'm talking about last Thursday's acquittal of Jose Garcia Zartar. Now, it might be old news to you, but for some, they're just kind of catching up. The shooting sparked renewal calls for stringent immigration laws, building a wall along the U.S.-Mexican border. And because of Zarta's acquittal, it's basically stoking those fires for people. They're really for the wall. People in favor of the wall have taken to social media with hashtag Kate's Wall. You can look it up, hashtag Kate's Wall, to condemn the court's decision to release a felon who was illegal in the country at the time of Steinle's death. And by the way, just a little FYI here, a little reality check here, because I give you the daily infusion. The reality check is, if this guy wasn't in our country, Kate Steinle would have been alive today. That's real. That's reality. That's fact. Now, among those fueling the online movement was some white nationalist and alt-right leader Richard Spencer, encouraging others to join him in Lafayette Square, the nation's capital, on Sunday afternoon to demand Trump build Kate's Wall. We don't need white nationalists. We don't need the alt-right to tell Donald Trump to build the wall. He's already going to build the wall. Seriously. It was a campaign promise, and they're moving forward on it. This was disgraceful. This was upsetting. But we don't need hateful groups. They're free to demonstrate. They can do what they're wanting to do, but I'm just pointing it out that that's what they're doing. Yes, Donald Trump will build the wall. It's not just them. It's just anybody that voted for Donald Trump wants him to be able to just do this. And yes, we should build it when it's hot. This man got away with it. And unfortunately, if we don't do something about these activist judges and the Department of Justice, doesn't do something about this, this is going to happen increasingly on our streets here in America. We have to put an end to the so-called sanctuary cities. This is, you want a cause? There you got one. Because this should be all our causes and all of our concerns. This is not good for America. This is not good for our cities, and for anybody else to paint that picture, that portrait of these sanctuary cities is definitely drinking Jim Jones Kool-Aid, because it is killing. It is lethal. It is lethal, and it's the same Kool-Aid that people drink daily by watching the mainstream media and sucking in the propaganda pieces that they put out, touting why it's so important to keep sanctuary cities. And people believe it because it's not anti-immigrant, and that's what they buy into. Because it's anti-immigrant if you believe any other way. That's how the left, plain and simple, that's the way, that's why people support it, because they think they're doing a lot of good by keeping it open and not closed. See how well it's worked for Germany, by the way. Just saying. We just don't need the worst coming over. And listen, when Donald Trump said what he said that caused a firestorm about the bad hombres coming over and some that I suppose are good, he's right. He's right. How many Kate Steinleys? I can't tell you how many DUIs from illegal immigrants killing innocent people in this country this past year. And then the year before that, it continues growing exponentially. Illegals should not even be here, period. Should not even be a conversation. And just the mere facts that we're having the conversation on the radio about illegal immigration, it's the reminder of past administrations that did nothing about it. And now we have a president that actually wants to do something about it. And this is the backlash that he gets. This is not white lash, as some minorities put it. This is not illegal bashing. It's talking about what's right, what's fair. You know, they say, oh, what about the children and the DACA program? Now, the children, they all care. These bleeding hearts care about it. The only thing they care about is them being reelected. They care about the votes. That's the drum. This is the beat. This is the connection that they have. And that's it. They could care less about your family, and immigrants are being used. See, the good ones that have opened businesses that are actually legal, they're actually paying their taxes. Therefore, what Donald Trump is proposing, they like what President Trump is doing. And a lot of them voted for him. A lot. And you point that out to any liberal, they'll deny. Not one of them voted for him. Are you kidding me? I live in Florida. I know of plenty immigrants, okay, that are legal, okay, that from all over South America, you pick it. Colombia, Cuba, Mexico, they voted for Donald Trump. A lot of them did. A lot of Puerto Ricans voted for Donald Trump. I know it's so unusual. So was it an oxymoron to have a black vote for Trump? Or millions that did. And they're smart. They get it. Obama trying to meddle into the politics of trying to be relevant, apologizing for Donald Trump and trying to mirror his trips around the globe. It's unbelievable. Yeah, somebody told me he's not paying for it. Because I thought, wow, on his dime, isn't that so nice? He really believes in these causes. He's being paid by the resistance to do this, just to give him a job, because he doesn't want to sit around his libraries still being built, where he's going to brainwash people there because he's going to open up some kind of higher school of progressive thinking, i.e. curriculum, Saul Alinsky's Rules for Radicals. He's going to radicalize them like none other before. So that's going to be his twilight there in Chicago. I wonder how many law enforcement officials and security guards armed to the gills there at that place, because Chicago, man, you got to be packing. You can't. Oh, legally. But the gangs are. Yeah, the crime is just, it's horrible. Good luck, Obama, with your library in Chicago. Man, they should open up some Big Brother locations out there on every other block, to be able to provide some male role models that these kids, 1 in 3, by the way, that's the statistics, 1 in 3 families, black families without a dad. I mean, that's just, it's just known facts, and it's sad. That's the statistics. That's nationwide. There's a reason why this goes on in our city streets, but, you know, that's the real facts, and these are not concerns of Obama. People say, oh, it shouldn't be his concerns. Well, whose concern should it be? He claims to be black. He's a minority, and he claims that there's those that are not for them. Then make a difference there. But his time there to meddle in another president's politics, which no other president's done but this one. This one is the most arrogant that you've ever seen possible. Part of the resistance group funded by George Soros and many like him enable him to continue doing this foolishness. And yes, what he's trying to do is undermine the president around the globe for everything that he's doing, apologizing for Donald Trump, saying, we're going to get rid of him. Just discredit.